You're looking at the redesigned 2020 Ford Explorer, the latest version of the vehicle that kicked off the entire SUV craze back in 1991. Almost 30 years later, it no longer looks like a box on wheels, but it remains a midsize family hauler, complete with the latest powertrain, safety, and infotainment technologies. Several versions are available, and they include XLT, Limited, ST, and Platinum. This one is the luxurious Explorer Platinum, and with a sticker price of more than $62,000, it costs as much as a luxury vehicle. Now, before you keel over and have a heart attack over that number, keep in mind that a base 2020 BMW X5 without a single option on it costs $180 more than this fully loaded Ford. Now, you can tell this is the fancy model thanks to its satin aluminum finish on the exclusive grille design, door handles, lower body, and tailgate trim. These polished 21-inch wheels are available only on platinum trim, and what they degrade in terms of ride quality, they upgrade in terms of looks. Now, the new Explorer moves to a rear drive platform, so while a lot of the design cues are similar, the proportions are completely different. A short front overhang, a long dashboard to axle ratio, and a tapered tail all emphasize the change. In my opinion, especially in higher trim levels with the bigger wheel and tire sets, this is a good-looking SUV. Oh, and this paint color is called Rich Copper. When you buy a new Explorer, you've got to choose between a turbocharged 2-liter four-cylinder in the XLT and Limited, a 3.3-liter V6-based gas-electric hybrid option for the Limited, or a twin turbocharged V6 in the ST and the Platinum. Clearly then, this is the twin turbo 3-liter V6. But in Platinum trim, it doesn't make as much power as in the racy ST. Here you get 365 horsepower and 380 pound-feet of torque, fed to a standard all-wheel drive system through a 10-speed automatic. Inside, Platinum trim equips the Explorer with premium leather, upgraded floor mats, and illuminated door sill trim plates. My test vehicle's got the optional premium technology package, which includes this 10.1-inch portrait-style infotainment system display, a 14-speaker premium sound system from Bang & Olufsen, and upgraded front seats complete with a massage function. Oh yeah, massaging seats. I never get tired of them. And these are both heated and ventilated too, and there's a heated steering wheel. For the second row, you can choose between these captain's chairs or a three-person bench seat. Now, the captain's chairs are a little snug for a guy my size, but they're comfortable, they're heated, and rear window sunshades are perfect for hauling babies and reverse-facing car seats. Moving the Explorer to a rear-drive platform takes a toll on third-row seat comfort. The new one's not as comfortable or accommodating as the previous front-drive Explorer was. So you're going to want to reserve that third-row seat for kids, or you're just going to want to keep it folded down, because behind the third row seat, you've only got 18.2 cubes, including this underfloor storage area. If you fold both third row seats down, you've got 47.9 cubic feet. And speaking of cargo volume, if you fold down the second row captain's chairs, the maximum number is 87.8 cubic feet. The new Explorer is loaded with technology. From adaptive LED headlights with automatic high beam operation to fully autonomous active park assist 2.0 technology, the Explorer scratches tech geeks where they itch. Highlights of the 10.1-inch Sync 3 system include Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, Alexa and Waze integration, Ford Pass Connect services, a 4G LTE Wi-Fi hotspot, 911 assist, and navigation. This bigger screen is an option on ST and Platinum trim, and frankly, I think I like the standard 8-inch screen, which is mounted horizontally, because it better integrates with the interior design. On the safety front, Ford Copilot 360 Assist Plus is standard on every version of the Explorer, except for the XLT, where it's an option. Now, in addition to the usual list of driver assistance systems, it includes adaptive cruise control with stop-and-go capability, lane centering assist, speed limit sign recognition, and evasive steering assist. That last one helps out when you have to suddenly swerve to avoid an obstacle of some kind. Now, you're going to want all of this technology because at the start of 2020, the Explorer had not yet earned a top safety pick rating from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. Specifically, in the small overlap frontal impact test, the crash test dummy's legs suffered some pretty severe injury. So the SUV got an acceptable rather than a good rating, which disqualifies it from the top rating. Don't buy an Explorer Platinum thinking you're going to be getting a more luxurious version of the Explorer ST, because you're not. From the detuned engine to the softer suspension, this version of the Explorer is meant for cruising. Acceleration is strong, especially if you switch into sport mode, or if you want to conserve gas, you can use eco mode. Now, most of the time, I tested the vehicle in normal mode, and out on my testing loop, I got 18.4 miles per gallon. That's less than the EPA official rating of 20 miles per gallon in combined driving. Now, the 10-speed automatic transmission behaved itself most of the time, Occasionally there were some clunky low speed shifts, but for the most part, it did a very good job of managing the power. Paddle shifters come in handy when you want to hustle, but chances are that won't be very often. No doubt, the steering and brakes are commendable, and the new Explorer feels stiffer and more athletic than the old one. Platinum trim, however, prefers smooth pavement. Bumps and undulations unsettle it more than I expected, making me think this pricey version of the SUV could use an adaptive damping suspension. Also, it's worth noting again that while the 21-inch wheels look great, they do have a negative impact on ride quality. Ford's move to a rear drive platform for the new Explorer is great from a styling and dynamic perspective, but it compromises the SUV's ability to serve as a legit three-row SUV. Still, I'd wholeheartedly recommend this vehicle if it had gotten a top safety pick rating from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. After all, when you're buying a family hauler like this one, safety's of paramount importance. Many of the Explorer's competitors perform better in this regard. For the 2020 model year, they include the Honda Pilot, Hyundai Palisade, Kia Telluride, Mazda CX-9, Nissan Pathfinder, and Subaru Ascent. None of those models comes with a hybrid option or a performance-tuned ST trim or a twin-turbocharged V6. So if those things are high on your list of must-haves, then you're going to want to use the link below to find out what you'll pay for a Ford Explorer at a dealership near you. Until next time, safe travels.